the rock on the tortoise's back. This was the time when the tortoise did not have shells on its body. One such tortoise was running a race with a deer. Suddenly, he tripped and fell down from a deep rocky hill. When he woke up, he was spinning on his back. He felt dizzy. He also felt a lot of pain. When the tortoise tried to get up, he could not. He felt something hard and heavy on his back. He realized that he had a cracked rock on his wrinkly body. The deer came down the hill and tried to pull the rock off the tortoise's back. However, the tortoise screamed in pain because the rock would not come off. Then the deer said, "You look better with the rock and it will protect you from the sun. Now let us have another race." The tortoise said, "No thanks," and he curled up inside his rock. Since then, the tortoise had a shell forever. The leopard's spots. A leopard and his wife were invited to a jungle party. They both wanted to look very special. So they decided, "Since each of us has a plain yellow coat, let's paint something on it." The leopard brought a pint of black paint but could not decide what to paint on their bodies. After a while, the leopard and his wife looked at each other and shouted in unison, "Spots of black!" They both painted black spots on their yellow coats and went to the party later that night. Everyone at the party loved their new creation. Soon all the leopards painted black spots on their coats. After a while, the leopard and his wife were tired of the spots. However, when they tried to wash off their coats, the paint had sunk in well beyond the fur. They could not get it off. The other leopards could not get it off either. To this day, leopards still cannot get their spots off. The clever crocodile. When hippopotamuses lived on land, there was a hippo king named Lionel. He had a beautiful wife and 7 children. The king loved to give big feasts, but strangely, no animal knew his name except for his wife. During one feast, Lionel said to his guests, "You all have attended many of my feasts, and yet none of you know my name. If you cannot say my name, you are requested to leave." As all the animals left, a crocodile said, "What if I could say your name in the next feast?" Lionel said, "Then I will live in the water forever." The crocodile thought of a plan. He dug a hole and buried himself. When Lionel's wife was walking to the river, she tripped over him and screamed, "Lionel, please help me." Thus, the crocodile learnt the hippo king's name. At the next feast, he said it as promised. Lionel and his family went to live in the river. Foolish monkeys. Once, heavy rains were flooding the riverbank, and all the animals were running up the hills. Some monkeys had climbed up the treetops to save themselves. When they saw the swimming fish, one of the foolish monkeys said, "The fish are going to be drowned. See how they are struggling in the water." The other monkey joined in. "I think they were left behind because they do not have legs." The first monkey said, "Let us help them to get out." One by one, the monkeys brought all the fish out of the water and put them carefully on the dry land. The first monkey said, "They were tired, so they are sleeping. Had it not been for us, all these poor fish would have been drowned." The other monkey said, "When they wake up, they will be very grateful." The foolish monkeys did not know that the fish were all dead. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.